everyone when I get back.
Kim and I are going to have some chicken tortellini soup soon. Very excited. Deal. Pizza's on me.
Deal.
What?
What? Pizza. Chloe's buying pizza? Chloe, you better fucking buy some pizza for me. Aw, what a fucking delight.
He was standing over there. I was
what a delight of a little girl. Good lord. Don't wave to me. You're gonna blow my fucking cover. What the worst little girl. The worst. I'm kidding. Me new for president. Thank you. I will be taking no questions at this time. Come on, let's start the pile of bodies. Let's start it. Oh, damn, Kim, I was seeing that too. Oh, whoa, I didn't see him. Wait, did I just kill him with a...
Anyone else? No?
I just killed him with a fucking nut shot. Killed him by kicking him in the balls.
I don't think that's possible.
Chloe just kicked that man so hard in the balls, in the testicles, that he died.
I need to go back to birth.
That he died. God damn, Chloe. Chloe's like, reverse birth kick. Kick your testicles right back into your stomach. All right, we're getting really gross. I'm sorry. I don't really apologize, though. This is funny. I kicked him in the balls, then knocked him off the roof. I was expecting Nadine to go like, really? Boost up? What are we, children?
Thank you.
Oh, she did a scramble. Wait, did she just scramble up? Wait a second. Did she just scramble up? Oh my god, she did. Shadow of the Tomb Raider is dead, everybody. We've done it. We've done it. We've incorporated the one good thing that was in fucking Shadow of the Tomb Raider and we put it in Lost Legacy. She scrambled up. She didn't. She used the momentum of her body against clawing at the wall and pushed herself upwards. And Shadow of the Tomb Raider did that, and that was the one cool thing I thought it had over Uncharted. And now Uncharted has done. If I'm, you know, maybe I'm misreading the animation I just saw. This is a very nice scene. Anyway, that's not the point. The point is, fuck Shadow of the Tomb Raider.
Meet you back at the car.
Yep. Ah, right where I left it.
Whoa.
Maybe I should take the train.
I didn't mean to hit circle. I hit circle. Wow.
Yep. Ah, right where I left it.
Oh my god, that was very funny.
Let's just enjoy the serenity, shall we?
Okay, I have to.
What a dumb question. So much for that.
All right, I had to. I'm sorry. I really wanted to. I just wanted to see what would happen.
Let's just enjoy the serenity, shall we?
Oh my god. Okay, so I'm going to try to run these people over. It's not going to go well, and I'm going to die. Oh my god, I said it flying! Oh my god! I said it fucking flying! You know, honestly, Uncharted 4 to this game, to Last of Us Part 2, I really wonder if the next game that Naughty Dog is going to do is just going to be full-length open world with like a really strong narrative. I don't know, it feels like they're building to that. And I mean, I could be wrong, obviously. I don't know what the fuck Naughty Dog has planned. But that really seems like the direction they want to take their games. More and more towards open world. Which I'm not against, by the way. You know, I'm not inherently against that, but it is interesting to me. I mean, maybe it's just that they want open world in their games. Not that they want to do an open world game entirely, but I don't know. Very interesting to see the through line between Uncharted 4, Lost Legacy, and The Last of Us 2, though. As a gamer nerd. Gaming nerd. That's redundant. I am a gamer, so I'm a nerd, but you know, whatever. behind the waterfall? You're technically obligated to do that if you're a game developer. I don't make up the rules, by the way. I'm just telling you what's happening. There has to be something behind at least one of these waterfalls. Otherwise, this is a fake video game. I don't believe that it's real. Wow, nothing behind any of these? This is a fake video game, y'all. I've made an incredible discovery. Whew, can't believe Naughty Dog sold us like this. Just awful. Yeah, and I got more sniper ammo out of that. That was clutch, Preston. That was clutch. Come on. I stealth killed him. He couldn't aim at me. And then I refilled sniper ammo immediately. That was awesome. Look at that. Look at this, everybody. Oh my god. Oh my god. I got that shot. What the fuck? I got that shot. Holy shit. That's not good, Nadine. I'm sorry. Yeah, that's something you can do in Uncharted 4, so I was confident you could do it in Lost Legacy.
Shit. Another one down.
Another one bites dust. Another one bites the dust. Hey, I'm gonna get you too. Another one bites the dust. Yeah, that was a falcon punch if I've ever seen one. Look at that. Perfect. Gotta love it. Yes, Kim? Yeah. I love this fucking silenced pistol so much.
That's a lot of them. You all right?
I was talking about this in PS Premiere, how I think these spaces, these wide open spaces, you could say, don't really add much to this game, but I didn't feel that way in Uncharted 4. But there was like a little bit of dissent or discussion in PS Premiere about, like, well, some people felt like it was a reverse, that it actually didn't add much in Uncharted 4, but it felt better here, or felt worse. I can't quite remember. But, yeah, I don't know. In Uncharted 4, it's like I felt like my destination was always near. I kind of knew what I was doing. But in this game, it just feels like too wide, too unfocused. I don't know. So that's my kind of criticism of it so far. I mean, I just like the narrow segments more than I enjoyed this. That's just the bottom line right there. Probably because Stone Cold says so, but I don't know. Who knows? Oh yeah, lockpicking. I forgot to bring this up to Stubbs. God damn it. Oh wait, no, I did bring this up to Stubbs. So, I have an update from Stubbs. So, he has told me that because she only gets out one bobbing pin, this is not realistic, y'all. She would need at least two or three bobbing pins to actually do what she's doing here. She wouldn't just use the same one over and over again. It would probably snap or something. He didn't give me all the details, but basically he said, no, that's not realistic. So, just want everybody to know. Chloe is doing some fake-ass lockpicking right here.
Oh, shit. They've made us.
Reckless time. That's my mix of stealth and recklessness.
Good.
So nice, we had to do it twice.
Near miss there. This is right.
Okay, so far so good. First try! Holy shit, I did it first try.
Come on over. Nice. Right behind you.
It's gonna be cool to know I played this whole franchise. I don't think there are any franchises that are as long as Uncharted that I've actually completed. I've always missed a game, or, you know, just wasn't gaming when it came out or something, or just never felt like I could get into it. So I don't know. It's kinda cool to say that I played the whole franchise now. Oh, I was asked on PS Premiere where this is going to be in my ranking. I think it's going to be probably my third favorite behind Uncharted 2, but certainly very far ahead of 1 and 3. So if that makes any sense. That's kind of where it'll be.
The Beverly Clary died.
Who?
The Beverly Clary. She wrote those books.
Those books? Wow.
Like Ramona. The Mouse books.
Oh, if you give a mouse a cookie?
I think so. Maybe not. I don't
want to
lie because it's stupid.
Stupid. Why did you say it like that?
I don't know.
So you're doing it again.
Gouda.
Kim, are you turning into Dracula?
I want some Gouda.
You're turning into cheese Dracula, apparently.
Yeah, this is our inside joke where Dory makes fun of me.
Wow, okay. First off, I don't need to be called out. The second, your laugh does sound like the Pillsbury Doughboy, and there's nothing you can do to stop it. And by the way, I think it's adorable. You're the one who takes it as an insult.
Because have you seen the Pillsbury Doughboy?
It doesn't matter. It's a cute laugh.
It's a Doughboy.
It's a cute laugh. But check out this watch. Oh, thank God, combat. I never thought I'd be so excited to see AAA combat in a game.
Yeah, I remember. Are you having doubts?
Right. I don't take left. That. I take right.
Do you? What the?
Oh, God! Did you see that, Chris? Oh, my God. Oh, my God. So she fucking grabbed one. The other guy went to get her. She just kicked him away and then kicked him into the river. Nadine's a fucking badass. I didn't realize she was going so soon. So I didn't go, and wow.
That works too. Nice job. Probably more where that came from. Right.
That was such a badass moment. I'm absolutely clipping that. The other guy came at her, and she's just like, nope, and just kicks him, like, right in the leg or the stomach. I'm not sure which. And, yeah, wow. Kim isn't impressed, though. Oh, that was so cool. That was so cool.
Slow down. Slow down. Well, at least I've still got my dignity.
Do you? Questionable, Chloe. Questionable. I just realized her name's Chloe. Makes me think of Life is Strange. What's up, sweetie?
Nothing.
You mean you're scratchy? Kim does this thing where she will confuse the words itchy and scratchy, and now those words are never simple for me like they used to be. How?
Point taken, universe.
Wow. Yeah, this day is just shitting on Chloe. It's not being kind to me either in terms of this game. I still think they should have just made this like a 2-hour DLC or something. I don't know. Move some things around, cut some things out. This just feels like unnecessary to me. But that's just me. I also just feel like Uncharted's been done out. Uncharted 4 is really where they should have ended it. It was the perfect Uncharted game. I don't think you could have made a better Uncharted game than that. I legit don't know what to do. Because, like, no matter what I do, I die. They've got rockets, too? Are you joking me? Like, are you kidding? I'm already fighting an APC. Now they have snipers and rocket launchers? Like, really? This is just absolutely bonkers. Oh, I can't fire the RPG. God. Go up! Go up! God! Just, like, go up!
Yes! Off to a good start.
Jesus! All I pressed the whole time. Oh, I thought I took him down. Oh, my God. Just jump. All I want to do is jump, and the game is making that so hard. Like, just jump. And I couldn't jump. It didn't let me. All I wanted to do in that situation was jump, the most basic thing in any video game, and it's like, no, you can't jump. Just jump over the fucking thing and then grapple the tree. That's all I'm trying to do. That's it. That's all. And the game just won't let me. It is so incredibly frustrating because I'm just going to die in a second if it doesn't let me. That is unbelievable how bad this is. That is the second time that's happened, and it shouldn't be happening once. And I got stuck there too. You noticed that I couldn't even do it then. Like, she just jumped off of the building and then stuck to the fucking railing instead of jumping forward. Like, how did we move backwards between Uncharted 4 and Lost Legacy? I don't understand how that's possible. But that's what we've done here. I don't see how that's possible. Sorry for getting so frustrated, but I was honestly trying to be patient with this game, but bad puzzle, bad chase sequence, and then a bad combat encounter? Like, I can only be patient for so long with a video game. At some point, it's just negligence. And, like, you can't have things like that in these kinds of situations. Like, you simply cannot have bad movement options when you're getting shot at by a fucking APC. Like, you just can't have that. Because I'm gonna die in a second if I don't move. And instead of actually having good options for me, the game's like, well, guess you're gonna die. Kim is looking for gifts for other people to rub in my face. And she's claiming it's from both of us. Of course it's from both of us. Alright, I gotta go down. Kim loves when I go down. Like, go down. Like, oh man, now I realize how that sounds. That's not how I meant it. Ugh. Well, stream's over. That's not how I meant it. I meant it when you, like, you know, like, you're going down. Not like... I'm living with a heathen. That's gonna ruin the stream. And of course now I have to clip it because there's no way I can't clip a clip like that. I'm trying. It won't let me. Just let me go on the turret. Oh my god. I died. Are you kidding? All I wanted to do was go back around and get on the turret. And the fucking game's like, what you actually want to do is jump off the fucking truck. It's just like, this is beyond parody. All I tried to do was press triangle so I could fucking shoot at whatever I need to shoot at. Like, that's incredible. That is, like, beyond parody to me. That, like, I could not even get around to the fucking turret.
It's
like unbelievable. All I wanted to do was get around. I don't know where the snipers are, Nadine. I would take aim at them if I knew where they were. Turret, and I repeatedly pressed triangle. I repeatedly tried to, like, jump onto it or jump over something so I could get on it. And the game's like, no. What you actually want to do is jump to your death.
Trading the tusk for a bomb.
Like, it's just unbelievable to me how bad the contextual reading in this fucking game is. See? I wasn't trying to jump off the train. But, like, I move closer to that side, and the game's like, well, what you obviously want to do is you want to fall off the train and die. Clearly, that's what anyone would want to do. Like, okay. At this point, the devs are just fucking desperate to extend how long this game goes on. Not only is the front door welded shut, but so is the hatch. Now we have to hit a switch to divert the train. And while that's going on, we have to fight people with guns again, even though I've killed about, like, 50 people to get up this fucking train. Just give me the satisfaction of killing all those people so I can just end the game already. Like, this is... They're so dragging this game out. Like, this game just feels like DLC that should have ended hours ago. Which, originally it was DLC. And it really, really shows. Like, I got behind cover. Like, the game tells you to repeatedly when you die. And it's like, it just doesn't do anything. So, like, what's the point? Fuck y'all.
Go, go, go.
Fuck y'all. Fuck y'all. Fuck y'all. Fucking die.
Alright, back to the switch.
Good.
The sheep will need their shepherd, and you...
Shut the fuck up, dude.
I will die 1,000 deaths before I let you...
No. I will die 1,000 deaths, my dude. I will die 1,000,000 times. Don't you worry about it. I'll do all the dying.
It's like you said. Progress. Demand sacrifice.
Fraser, we need to go.
Smug little shit.
Run!
They're pulling a Batman here. They're not gonna kill him, but they're not gonna save him either. Oh, big Uncharted 2 vibes right here. Oh my god. Okay, thank god this game can be over.
Please?
Jesus, Sam.
Oh, Sam!
Alright, climb up, I got you.
How did he survive?
Oh my god.
It's all muscle. That's what they all say.
Yeah, I agree. That ending was pretty cool. Blowing somebody up with their own nuclear bomb.
What the hell did you guys get out of that?
I forgot what it was.
But it's a bomb. Figuring that out.
So I don't know if this segment is going to be muted or not. I'll try to say my I'll say some of my thoughts right now, and then maybe I'll repeat them after the credits. Because sometimes I get muted during these segments because of copyrighted music, which is stupid because... Obviously, Naughty Dog have paid for the rights for them to use it, and I have the rights to stream this game, which should mean I have the rights to fucking stream the music that they have. But, you know, Twitch kind of sucks about this, so. Yeah, I really liked the game at the beginning, and then I didn't really care for the open world stuff. I really didn't like a puzzle and then a chase sequence. And then some wonky combat and controls after that kind of made for a iffy experience at best. And then it got better. We met that elephant and there was some cool exploration stuff and some interesting puzzles, some good character work, some good writing. But then in the last 45 minutes, absolutely like just ridiculously difficult combat. It just made the DLC feel even more plotting than it already was. I didn't care for it, honestly. Something was off, and I don't know if it was me, but like I've played every single Uncharted game, and I played Shadow of the Tomb Raider recently, and I didn't have, even in Tomb Raider, which I have so many bad things to say about. Like, I didn't have the kind of controls issues that I had in this game. And it's just, especially in that last 45 minutes, it must have been like 4 or 5 times I died because the context for all of my moves seemed to be wildly off. And I don't know, it was just weird. So, I mean, basically, if it wasn't for good character work and good writing, except for the villain, I mean, the villain's kind of tropey and just whatever. But, like, I really love Chloe and Nadine's relationship. And that's the focal point, and that works. So, I mean, it has a solid basis. The graphics are great. The voice acting is great. Again, I don't really care for the fact that, Nadine is voiced by, I can't remember her name. But I don't like that she's voiced by a white woman. I don't think that's good. I don't care if the actress trained for the role or whatever. They should have hired somebody else. I'm sure there are plenty of other people who are adequately talented for it. I can't remember her name. But anyway, she's very talented, and she does a good job. It's just knowing that it's actually a white person doing it, and it kind of ruins it for you. But for me, anyway. But yeah, I would skip this game. I honestly, in general, in Uncharted, I would just play 2 and 4 and call it a day. But that's me. And then play Lost Legacy if you really want to see what happens to Chloe and Nadine. Because you could do 2, 4, and then Lost Legacy, because it does kind of cap off what happens to Sam, and then what happened to Chloe, and what happened to Nadine. But I don't know that I really needed this story. Like, this just, that's the main problem with this game. It feels unearned. It feels unnecessary. I didn't really care what happened to Nadine. I didn't really care what happened to Chloe or Sam. Like, I was happy with where Uncharted 4 took off, or left off. But anyway, yeah, those are my thoughts. So, just in case I got muted earlier, basic thoughts on the game are it's a kind of above-average action-adventure game that happens to be an Uncharted game. Its main problem is it feels like a DLC that should have just been a couple of hours, but instead Naughty Dog decided to pull out all the stops and make it, like, 8 hours, which just feels super unnecessary and really dragged out. Some of the controls are really wonky, and the driving is really bad. The graphics are great, the voice acting is great, except I don't like that Nadine's voice actor is done by Laura Bailey. That's her name. And I think that's mostly it. It would be a solid game if they had cut out some of this stuff. If they had made it like 2 hours or 4 hours, I don't know. Because unlike the next game we're going to play, Outer Worlds, it doesn't feel like it should have been that long. Like, the DLC I'm about to play feels like it really should have been as long as it is, because there's just a ton of content. But Uncharted, it just feels like they're stretching the limits of what they can get out of this. I think more than that, the game just feels unnecessary. Like, just besides just being a DLC that feels too long, basically. I mean, I know it's a full game, but it feels like a DLC that's too long. It also just, I don't need to know about Sam, Nadine, or Chloe. That wasn't something, like, I was really looking for in an Uncharted game. Like, I like all these characters, but do I need another story about them? Not really. But anyway, here's Wonderwall. I mean, Outer Worlds. Yep. 2 days, gonna be a day. Sorry. I'm gonna get muted on Twitch forever now.